extreme, but
just
to say that the situation of Goldman Sachs does not mean at all that we are out of the crisis. It doesn't mean that the financial community is getting better, and here I agree with you, Goldman Sachs is just one exception in a situation where the financial world cannot escape the real crisis that's still going on. And the basis of the crisis is not there. The basis of the crisis is that the twin deficits are still there. They have to be financed, and you have to grab money where it is. So the financial markets have been bringing money back, selling some empty boxes, and they brought that money back. They got money from the Chinese, from the Japanese, from the Gulf sovereign wealth funds, but that's not sufficient. Solving the crisis is restructuring all the relationships that should exist so that the economic situation of the United States becomes sound like the ones that you find somewhere else.
Max, to go back to these figures, isn't Goldman Sachs doing all that could be expected of it? It took on a $10 billion loan, it's repaid that loan, and now it's making money. That's what banks are meant to do, isn't it?
Where's my participation in this Goldman Sachs? You know, as part of these bailout bank programs in the past, the citizens get warrants, and they participate in the upside, and these banks like Goldman are buying back their stock on the cheap. I don't get my warrants. Plus, they've artificially dropped interest rates to 1% and lower. Therefore, as a saver in America, as a saver, as someone who I should be lauded and applauded for being a saver and helping the capital system in America, Goldman Sachs owes me personally, I figured, at least $10,000 in interest income that they've stolen. They've taken it right out of my pocket, just like those bonuses at Goldman Sachs being paid this year were taken right out of the starving Americans' pockets. The homeless in America have Goldman Sachs to thank for their homelessness and starvation right now. They took their money from their pockets. They put it in their bonuses for this year. That's unconscionable. That's a financial terrorist crime. I'm not kidding. They should be at the Hague.
But Max,
they should be. They should be taken to the Hague. They're absolutely violating human rights. It's a human rights issue.
But Max, look at it the other way. What would be the consequences of letting all the banks and Goldman Sachs first go down? Remember the situation that happened after Lehman Brothers went down. The effect is a very, very astounding effect. It was not only on Lehman Brothers, but it was on the confidence in the system globally.
You're
so are you ready?
Stockholm Syndrome. You're a fall in love with your captors. You believe that Charles Manson, who is Hank Paulson and Tim Geithner, is somehow got your best interest at heart. Well, let me tell you something. They don't.
They are not exactly my type.
If you're on the floor bleeding, that's what they live for. They're not somebody you let them fail. Of course you have to let them fail, because in capitalism, in American society, the losers have to fail to allow the people who are entrepreneurial and winners to take place. There's plenty of banks that could have taken these place of these other banks. You don't need to put shysters and charlatans on Wall Street who have stealing with impunity and give them a break. And they only paid 1% taxes last year.
But what's the way out? I'm worrying about the way out.
One second. Do different rules apply for Goldman Sachs? We were just talking about the fact that Hank Paulson was the CEO of Goldman Sachs, Robert Rubin the same.
And I would say even more than that. Hank Paulson, when he left Goldman Sachs, he left with a golden parachute of $500 million. Today, he is making speeches against golden rules. Do what I do, but don't do,
Is Goldman Sachs so enmeshed in government that it's almost impossible to separate the two?
Well, I let Max have the responsibility for that. But what I'm doing, I'm looking forward. Are we going to look for a way out? And the way out is the G20. And the G20 has to put new rules for the new relationships and new Bretton Woods. Bretton Woods 3 has to be there, and we have to operate, even in the United States,
Max, is that the
against
way forward?
That hanky-panky.
Well, I think first you need some transparency and accountability. Which is, this is another problem with the Obama administration. They just want to move forward. They don't want any transparency or accountability for the war criminals from the previous administration or the banking fraudsters and banking terrorists of the Paulson period. You need accountability. You need transparency. You need some idea that says that these banks have to disclose. You can't have the bankers going to Congress and saying, for example, we can't audit the Fed because if you audit the Fed, we're going to crash your system. We're holding you hostage.
Absolutely.
You can't allow that. That's in the United States under the Constitution. That is a high crime and misdemeanor. That is actually treason, according to the U.S. Constitution, to have a U.S. Representative say, we can't audit us because otherwise we're going to crash your system. What's that? How is that different than Osama bin Laden? You tell me how the difference is. They're causing as much damage. They're causing as much loss of life. And probably much more. Mm. I mean, Paulson and Geithner are pussycats. Obama's a pussycat compared to Paulson and Geithner in terms of pure damage.
Mm. Yeah, but listen, Max, this is not only about the Fed. This is about the Bank of England. This is about the Banque Centrale Européenne, European Central Bank, where you got the assets that have gone up, not through sound instruments, but through the files that banks cannot recover anymore.
After Building 7 exploded on 9/11, they can't get the records anymore?
It's the whole world system that has to be revalued. That's why I was talking about the G20. I was talking with an investment banker from the United States, and he told me, you know what is an investment bank today in the United States? It's a left side and a right side. On the left side, nothing is right. But on the right side, nothing is left. That means the equity is not there anymore. Yeah. And now the system has to be reconstructed on sound basis. I agree with you on accountability. I agree with you on transparency. But this cannot be done only leaving the Wall Street and the Senate and Capitol Hill alone. We need to solve it together. The world, Europe has a role to play. Ooh, the emerging
yeah,
world to
play. Federal Reserve Bank, Bank of England, European Central Bank, they all report to Bank of International Settlements in Switzerland. And that's another black box, and that's another highly corrupt institution. And again, that thriving in the darkness of non-accountability and non-transparency. Now, the only solution going forward, if we're talking solutions now, if we're going to walk away from prosecuting the financial terrorists Paulson, Geithner, and Bernanke, which I don't know why we have to do that, but if we're going to walk away from that responsibility as citizens, the way forward would be to Bretton Woods III, which has as its basis some relation to gold. Gold is obviously the only way you're going to create a sound global economy in terms of returning some integrity to a currency. And some countries like China, for example, are aggressively buying gold right now because they realize that eventually when the system and this next wave crashes down, and it's going to have another massive banking crash in the next 6 to 9 months, I'll bet you lunch at Maxime's that there's another huge banking crisis in the next 6 months. When this finally does crash, the only thing left standing will be gold bullion, and China recognizes this, and this is why they're aggressively buying in anticipation of this moment.
Where I agree with Max is that the world needs a reserve currency that's credible. The dollar cannot be a reserve currency anymore because it's backed by two deficits that are so huge that are putting it to risk.
The Russians and Chinese are saying that as
absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely. But gold today, it's too late to put it there. We need to have a new special drawing rights set by a super IMF, which would be international with governance that will allow Europe to have a very, very high hand there. The emerging countries will have a high hand there and will determine the special drawing rights. That means a basket of currencies that will be credible with the dollar, with the euro, with the renminbi, with the yen, and with the main commodities, gold and oil. Gold and oil have to be there.
It's not too late for gold. That's like saying it's too late for honesty. It's too late for integrity. It's too late for civilization. A special drawing rights and a beefed up IMF. You're just putting the same guys in charge of more of fiat currencies, financial engineering, high frequency trading, fraud and deception, non-transparency, non-accountability, and financial terrorist crimes.
Going back to Goldman Sachs, those bonuses, it does rather suggest that the people running Goldman Sachs are grossly out of tune with the national
mood. No, come on. The bonuses idea and the paradis fiscaux, the fiscal havens idea is just a way to tell the people, don't worry about the main issues, we'll treat these relatively small issues. The real issue is that is the financial world linked to the real economic world? If it's not linked to it through derivatives and through virtual instruments that are misused because they are needed, but they are misused, then we do have problems. Don't forget that Goldman Sachs made about 3.5 billion profits. So the shareholders are benefiting from this.
They were given 3.5 billion from taxpayers in America. You call it a profit?
They
didn't make them. They stole them. If I go to a bank and I steal $1,000, you're going to say, I made $1,000. That's absurd.
The shareholder made money.
The shareholders are complicit. You know, if Goldman Sachs took Auschwitz public, they would sell shares to their friends and family and say, this concentration camp's a great business. Would you support Auschwitz concentration camp Goldman Sachs took it public? You know, the tragedy of 9/11 is that more of these Goldman Sachs bankers didn't go down. That's the ultimate tragedy. Goldman, here's the last of my money, Goldman. Take it. Here's the last money I have, you crooks. Take the last money I have. You're crooks. It's disgusting.
Well,
hard to believe sometimes, isn't it? just hard to believe that we've not only allowed this to happen, but like the revolving door at the FDA, where people work at Merck and then work for the FDA, and then people work for GlaxoSmithKline, work for the FDA, and then people work for Monsanto, go back to work for the FDA. We've allowed this quartocracy, this almost fascism. It's true fascism. And meanwhile, we've changed all our laws to be more like Germany was right in the 30s, right? Where nowadays you've got to take your shoes off when you fly because your mother might be Al-Qaeda, okay?